So in the last session, what we have discussed? The last session, what we have discussed, starting from introduction to AI, applications of AI, we have seen about the agents, types of environments, and we started exploring search strategies. So in the very immediate class, what we have seen about BFS and DFS, we have seen. Second stage, problem solving approaches using search strategies. It's a common topic for unit 1 and 2 actually. The reason that all the solutions towards AI-based problems, very classic AI-based problems, are being designed as trees. Solution strategies are converted into trees. Starting node will be there, the root of the tree. Goal node will be the leaf node of the corresponding tree. That's all. So people are trying to formulate graph and trying to solve this problem, especially undirected graph. I think we have seen these things through animation in the last session. So likewise, we have some other searching strategies also. So depending upon the application, we have to choose the corresponding searching algorithm to solve the problem. So on the day, you could able to see, I have shown you an animation for 8 puzzle problem. So by keeping a swap space, I am moving it, right? So by keeping the position of the swap space, I could able to construct the tree. So what are all the different levels of the corresponding I think it's visible. Yes, still I have not get into the PPT, man. It's the first slide. By keeping the swap space of that 8 puzzle problem, it will construct the successors of the corresponding swap space, and a tree will be constructed. At any one of the stages, by default, the result will be available in any one of the node. So how much levels I have traversed, at what depth that my result has been received, that will reflect the time and space complexity of the corresponding algorithm that I have used to solve my problem, right? By varying the other algorithm, algorithm X, algorithm Y, I could able to go for finding out lesser time complexity and space complexity. So this process has been molded and coined a name with ML and DL is going to be ensembling. Ensembling. So likewise, it's wise for AI, you can go for some hybrid algorithms. Do not stick only to any one specific algorithm. You can combine or you can extract the features of best features of algorithm X, algorithm Y, combine and use it. Normal common sense is equal to the usage of hybrid features. Okay. Depth limited search. Today we have seen DFS and BFS. It is the next version of DFS, depth limited search. The reason to introduce this searching technique is mandatorily I will go for all the nodes when I am going for DFS to avoid that. Once if you reach the goal state in any one of the level, automatically the solution need to be, the iteration need to be terminated. Possibly if you know in which level that solution will be exhibited, you can give the level also. Right? So you can do it in a programmatic way that give the level along with the DFS, you give the level up to which level that it need to iterate. That's all. That is what the difference between DFS and DLS. DLS equal to DFS plus you will give the level up to which level that it need to move forward. This graph will have level 3, up to level 3. But during programming, during the process of searching that you have given, that it is enough to search up to level 2, because you are reaching the goal state J through DFS algorithm in the second level itself. That means during the third iteration itself, you got it. Right? This is what DLS is. Especially where this DLS would be used in the beginning stages of identifying the brain tumors, clotting of blood be available in any strand of our brain. So to identify that location, this DLS can be simulated. It's a very basic example. Next one, UCS. It is like when you come across your computer networks. If you already come across your computer networks, you come to about Dijkstra's algorithm. So Dijkstra's algorithm is based upon slowest cumulative cost. I will transfer my packet from source to destination. The same algorithm here. Lowest cumulative cost, right? From S to A, and also here you have to go for the goal node, right? So if you go for SBG, cost will come as 9. If you go for SADG, cost will come as 6. If you go for S to G, SACEG, cost will come for 14. So the lowest cumulative cost can be applied over SADG only, right? So whenever you are going for the next successor, choose the node which is having the least cost. So by that you need to move forward to achieve the goal state. Okay, S represents the start state, G represents the goal state. And by comparing previous algorithm and this algorithm, you have to choose the application. Do not compare with their time complexity and space complexity. You need to fix it off the content, right? So if the environment is very known, right, episodic, if the environment is episodic, you can deploy UCS. It's a very casual case. You know some 10 to 15 paths to reach, like your traveling salesman problem. So traveling salesman problem can be solved using UCS. That's a very easy case. Identifying a machine in a network to transfer the data can be done through UCS. Router designing, IP table matching can be done through this UCS. So likewise, it is having some interesting applications in core computer engineering domains. IDDFS. Iterative deepening DFS. Okay. Version of DFS. Normally in the DFS, what it will do? It will go to A, next it will go to either choose B or C, right? So if you go to B, it will penetrate deeply. After B, it will go for D, it will go for the corresponding H. So likewise, it will go penetratively. But here we are going to combine the feature of both BFS as well as DFS. Best features, because I don't want to iterate it again. Okay. So the thing is, level by level, it will complete all the nodes by visiting. It will come forward. It will move forward. At any one of the level, if it had reached the goal state, means it won't move further. Again, we have reached the portion of our DLS also. Iterative deepening DFS. Especially the room cleaning or floor cleaning robots will be employed with this IDDFS. Okay. Even if it is going to be some image mapped vision based floor cleaning robots, also mapped with this IDDFS. It's very easy to design. You can purchase an Arduino board, incorporate a sponge, incorporate a rolling wheel from your toy cars, make the wheels to move using a normal propelling circuit, give the signal for the circuit from the board. In the board, have your Python program, or using cross compiler, you can have the Python program to make it to move forward the board. It's very easy to design a room cleaning robot for keeping your suction of your dust, that you could able to use your any small bag, any small pouch, or you can carry forward with the water based or any solution based cleaning sponge. So that's also possible, right? So such type of applications can be done through IDDFS. If you want to find or if you want to perform or simulate a treasure hunt, you can run with this IDDFS. Next one, bidirectional search. It is like your quick shot, actually. The quick shot, we will do shorting from both the sides by keeping binary search as the basic methodology. But here, the given graph that I could able to start traversing from the root node as well as the goal node. That is the idea. Root node is 1, goal node is 16. The point that where we are going to communicate would be the intersection. That could be the shortest path to achieve the corresponding entry. Right? Here, again, I'll be telling you, bidirectional search is a methodology. You can substitute any searching technique for reaching 19, for reaching 16 to the intersection node. You can employ BFS, DFS, DLS, anything. It's up to your wish. Even you can employ two different algorithms, for one for forward search and other for backward search. It's up to your wish. You can substitute and use. So that is the case. At which point they are going to communicate, you will get a path. That's all. So either the path from 1, 4, 8, 9, 10, 12, 16, or it may be 16, 12, 10, 9, 8, 4, 1. That could be the path. Next type of algorithms will start with the term heuristic. What is the term heuristic? Heuristic means based upon some condition, or based upon some cost, or based upon some arithmetic operation. Likewise, we could be able to give meaning for the term heuristic, heuristic search, or heuristic function. In this search algorithm, they have used a heuristic function. What is the heuristic function? That function could be made up of some arithmetical operation. So here you could be able to see f of n equal to g of n. This is the heuristic function. What is g of n actually? When I have to use f of n, if I'm going to travel from one node to other node, I have to use this g of n. What is g of n? This is estimated cost from node n to the goal. So that is the heuristic function. So you can define your own heuristics. So this is the place where we can start our research on search algorithms. Right? You can customize the heuristic function. So regarding best first search, right? So they are ready to construct the cost table based upon that. They are ready to construct the cost table from every node to reach the goal node. What is the cost? They have computed the cost and they have listed in the table. They have computed H of N. Okay. So I have mentioned as G of N here. Make it as H of N. So H of N they have computed. What is H of N? From that node, from node A to reach G, what could be the cost? I can't able to reach G directly. I have to go for successor. If I don't find goal node, again I will travel back. That cost also being counted till I am reaching G. What are all the values I am getting in the edges? That must be added. Final value could be that H of N value. Likewise, they have computed for all the nodes. From that, which is ready to generate my cumulative cost, that I am ready to travel and reach. So cost computation for each and individual node must be done through the process of basic search. So this is the starting algorithm to understand with the heuristic search. If I am going to improve the heuristics, this is A star search. Here I have included two parameters, G of N plus H of N. Cost to reach node N from start state. Cost to reach node N from goal node, right? For from both the direction. So which is going to be the cheapest one? That could be the function for F of N. So ultimately, when I'm going to work with the heuristics, my heuristics value could be low. That is the ultimate idea. So here I have computed by keeping the heuristics, right? For every node I have given that heuristic value, H of N, right? So G of N you have to compute. They have given H of N, right? You have to compute G of N. By adding with that, that you could be able to find out the shortest path, right? So if I'm going to a goal state directly from S, my cost would be 10. If I am traversing via the path A and C, my cost will be 6. Right? If I am traversing via these things, I could be able to run with the 7, A, C, D, G. If I am going through A, B, D, G, I need to spend some more additional cost. So which one is the cumulative lowest cost? Starting from your UCS, you could be able to observe this. For UCS, the basic algorithm itself like this, but here it's not like that. Depending upon my customization, I could be able to compute the heuristic function. You can change this heuristic function. For your application, you can change the heuristic function. Right? Depending upon the application, you can change this heuristic function. It is permissible. So, for example, you are going to Tomb Raider game. You are going to find out the treasure inside a tomb. So, in those cases, if you are going to fix up some evils inside the corresponding path for the player, that you could be able to fix up some. So before reaching the goal node, the player has to meet this many number of evils that can be fixed in some particular distance from the rotation. For that, you could be able to compute this. For example, square root of the given cost to reach from node N to goal node, or cube root of. So what is the value I am receiving through that cube root of H of N? That is the place I will keep one evil. So likewise, from that distance, I am going to keep one more evil. So likewise, I could be able to cumulatively employ my heuristic function to make that path to be fixed with the obstacles. See, I will be telling you the ways how can you use the heuristic function. You can use the heuristic function to reach the, to attain the path from start state to goal state. But alternative ways that I am conveying, you can, while designing applications, you can use the heuristic function for fixing up other parameters also. That is also applicable. It was discussed in your Russell Norvig artificial intelligence textbook. Okay, Russell Norvig. what are the other possibilities? At the end of the third chapter, you could be able to see research to continue. In that fourth point or fifth point, you could come across that how can we use this A star search in a different perspective, right? So here we are using only a basic operation plus. So you could be able to employ some complex operations that cannot be tracked. So these are all the basic searching techniques to be remembered for solving the problem in your AI paper. Depending upon this, you will get problems. I'll share the materials in the Google Classroom. Please use it. Again, I'll be telling you, still I have not given any deadline for the assignments. Work it out, submit it as early as possible. Now all are informed to type your complete roll number in the chat.